I made a copy of a former friend's house key with the intent to rob them. I still carry the key months later. Not sure where to start on this one. But it's been eating at me this entire week and I feel like I have to get it off my chest. For the last couple of years up until half a year ago, I used to help out the family of a girl I wanted to bone. Real champion of ethics here. From that simple desire, I got led down a path that I thankfully got away from, because that entire family is fornicating insane. Father is in prison for using and selling meth. Mom is a male entertainer addicted to alcohol and other body purifying substances. The daughter, the one I wanted to bone, was the textbook definition of a dumb blonde, plus she had extreme ODD. And the only slightly normal one was a 13-year-old daughter who their mother willingly bought alcohol and weed for. Despite this, they actually had some wealth hidden away. Getting a copy of their house key was easy when the mom left all her keys in my car on a solo trip to City Hall. After that, it was just a minute trip to the local hardware store, and spending $1.25 to get a copy. I was gone 5 minutes, and she didn't even have a clue she left them in my car. After that, it was just finding where the jewelry was hidden, and waiting for a good opportunity. They lived in a very poor part of town, where burglaries are common. But despite this, they didn't invest in any sort of anti-theft system anywhere. No cameras, no alarms, no animals, nothing. The big issue was at least one of them was always home. Despite this inconvenience, I found the jewelry in a little metal container stuffed back behind the store's worth of sex toys in the mom's closet. Easy to explore the house when everyone is blackout drunk at 3 AM. I obviously couldn't take it then. So I left it, and put all the gross fornicating toys right back where I found them. Now all I had to do, was wait for the opportunity. The closest I came, was when they all went to Florida for a week, but some other a-hole broke in an hour earlier, before I got there. The place was swarming with police and, only because the idiot had broken a window to get in, and alerted the neighbors. My plan would be to go through front with the key and lead through the back door in the garage, leaving it unlocked to make it look like they forgot to lock that door. They often did anyways, since it barely opens, and the top two hinges are missing. Since then, I've never gotten another opportunity. I've completely thrown all those psychos out of my life, but I still have that house key. It's actually right alongside my own house key and my car keys on my keychain. So that's my confession that's been eating at me. I don't feel better at all. I actually feel stupid that I cut them out, because I haven't had a drop of alcohol since then. The mob paid me and such for driving them around and doing miscellaneous tasks. I couldn't tell you why I still have the key. Maybe it's just the thought that I have this ridiculously easy crime I could commit, or that I have all this wealthy knowledge hidden behind one simple key. Would I do it now given the opportunity? No. It's not worth the time to scope a place and figure out when they next all leave together. I've got a fairly successful job now. Whatever jewelry was there, I make almost double in a month. Back then, I was jobless and living at my parents' house, since money was tight for me. TLDR. Got a copy of a key to a friend's house to later rob them, but the right opportunity never showed up. Also, my keychain is my PFP. If anyone is interested for some reason, the key on top is the copy of their house key. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. Have a nice day. Hashtag McAfee for Monday Night Football.